In this tutorial, we will learn how to use databases to store the data collected from various OSNs. We will start off with MySQL. MySQL is a database management system which uses a relational database and SQL. As first step, we will install MySQL. To do that, go to your terminal and type sudo apt-get install mysql-server. Press enter and enter your sudo password. Now you will be prompted for a password. Make sure that you take a note of it because you will need it later. In the next step, we will see how to configure MySQL. To do that, type sudo mysql secure installation. Enter current password for root. Now, do not change the root password because you have already set it. Therefore, press N. You can remove anonymous accounts by pressing N. And also press N for disallowing root login remotely. If you want, you can remove the test database or leave it as it is. We will choose to delete it. Let us reload the privilege tables now and press yes. This finishes off the installation of MySQL. Now, to check whether MySQL has indeed been installed, let's check the MySQL version by typing the command MySQL minus minus version. It says MySQL version 5.5.5 has been installed. You can test whether MySQL has indeed been installed or not by trying to log into MySQL. To do that, type MySQL minus u root minus p and press enter. Enter the password which you created for your MySQL admin account. And you are able to log in. Now, to connect Python to MySQL, we will need MySQL DB module. To do that, type the following command. Note that we are not typing apt-get install, but we are using the command apt-get build dep, which is used to build dependencies for a following package. Continue. Next, we will install the Python MySQL library by typing sudo pip install mysql-python. And we are done with the MySQL installation along with integration with Python. Now, to make sure that Python module and MySQL are indeed installed, let us try going to the Python CLI. Type Python and inside the console, import MySQL DB. If it has been successfully installed, there will be no error. Now we will see how to use MySQL. Log into your MySQL account by typing mysql minus u root minus p. Enter your password and you will be inside the MySQL prompt. Let's create a database to store data using the command create database OSN data. Now, let us create a table to store tweets collected via Twitter API. We will first need to switch to the newly created database by typing use OSN data. And now, we will create a table using the following command. Note that here we are setting the primary key as the tweet ID. Now we have a database and a table ready to store the data. Let us now look at how we can store previously fetched data from Twitter into a MySQL database. Let us go back to the script we wrote for collecting real-time data from Twitter. In case you had to monitor a set of keywords for a large amount of time, storing the output in a database can be helpful, so that it is indexed and can be easily queried later. Now let us look at the changes which we have made to the existing script to store data into a MySQL table. We start off with importing MySQL DB. Then we have specified the credentials to access MySQL. Note that in this case, the host will be localhost since we are accessing MySQL on our local machine. DB is the name of the database where we will store the data. Next, we have two functions, createConnection and closeConnection, which are used to open and close connection to MySQL. In the previous tutorial, we were tracking a keyword, #election2016, and simply printing the tweet text on the terminal. This time, additionally, we will store this into the database. Now remember, we have already created a table named tweets, which had two fields, tweet ID and text. We only need to execute the insert query to set the value of tweet ID and tweet text field. Note that the insert ignore command ignores the insertion of a new entry with previously existing primary key. Now let us save this file. And try running it. You will notice that in a while, the tweets will start coming. Now, open a new tab in the terminal and let us go to MySQL. Once you are on the MySQL prompt, switch to the database OSN data. Now if you run the command show tables, you will be able to see the list of tables in this particular database. We have the tweets table, which has the tweet ID and the tweet text from the streaming API running in parallel. Let us try to access the data in the tweet table. Type the command select star from tweets. You will notice that there's a bunch of text and at the bottom it says 12 rows inset. Let us verify the number of tweets present in the table so far. To do that, go to the previous command, but this time add count in front of the star and enclose it in the brackets. This command will count the number of rows in the table. Now we have 25 tweets in this particular table. The select query can also be integrated into Python script for a more effective data collection.